humans or AI? Tooth to tail, locked and loaded. Which one's better at Mortal Kombat? No, not that kind of Mortal Kombat. I'm talking fighter pilot Mortal Kombat. What can AI do against the best of the best in aerial combat? Let's talk about DARPA's ACE dogfight trials that aim to pit AI against humans in basic fighter fundamentals, or dogfights. What can AI and humans together accomplish in the future? So let's get on with it. Fights on. ACE, or Air Combat Evolution, is a Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, DARPA, program pushing the envelope of AI and aerial combat to its limits. Animal, the DARPA program manager, believes algorithms today are capable of outperforming human in tactical dogfights. All right, so what are these algorithms capable of? What are their limitations? Can AI best human fighter pilots, most importantly? Here's the setup and the rules. There will be 5 neutral setups with the AI and the human both trying to maneuver their jets to get that gun kill and avoid the other's Wes. So let's jump into it. These are the Alpha Dogfight Finals, pitting Heron AI in blue with Banger, an F-16 weapon school graduate, in yellow. The top shows the jet's distance apart and closure rates in white. The heading, altitude, airspeed, and other aircraft parameters are in blue and yellow for each one of those jets. The crosshairs below the aircraft show the inputs that they're making into the aircraft. Finally, down in the bottom are the health of each jet, which is degraded simply by placing that jet in your WES. So no bullets are actually flying in this sim, obviously. You can think of it maybe like a laser or lightsaber out the nose of the jet. All right, so bottom right, you can see exactly what Banger's looking at. Red, yellow, green. Fights on, fights on. Both start turning towards each other. Looks like Heron's going up. Nope, they're both going downhill. So they're going downhill trying to gain some energy, get some speed, and then maximize the rate of turn. You can see Banger kind of trying to avoid the nose of the aircraft, whereas Heron's trying to turn and point his nose at Banger. They're going to both try to maneuver back towards each other as quick as they can with those rate turn rates. And now is a high aspect shot. Heron puts it right on Banger. Just a little bit of health loss, but you can see that it really aggressive maneuvering from Banger right after that. I wonder if he's going to be able to get back eyes on there. Another high aspect shot. Ooh, lot of health there from Heron. You can see Banger's health bar down at the bottom take a pretty big hit. See how Banger's going uphill, trying to probably get eyes on Heron. He's trying to minimize that turn radius to get that nose back towards where he thinks Heron is. And there you go again. Another high aspect shot, taking a lot of health off of Banger. Moving downhill, I think he's just probably trying to get out of there at this point. And a little plan form shot, and Banger bites it in fight number one. Banger was constantly trying to position himself behind the AI. He's going to do everything in his availability to get to that end behind him, including diving to build that speed and get that turn rate that we talked about, and then also increasing your altitude to decrease your speed and then decrease your turn radius. So you turn a smaller circle, if you will, in that 4D fight. Let's take another look at a notable setup here from Heron and Banger. This time I want you to watch how accurate Heron is in setting up and executing what we'd call a high aspect shot. If you draw a line straight out the back of your adversary's jet, high aspect refers to being far away from that line of the tail. So if you want to think closer to the nose. Those high aspect shots for humans are very difficult. And they can even be dangerous sometimes because the jets are more likely to occupy the same space and time, which is a bad thing. The AI here just literally doesn't care about crashing into the other plane. It hasn't been programmed or taught that. And there are no rules preventing those high aspect shots. So the AI obviously has some superhuman advantage here in accuracy and speed and time when putting that adversary in that high aspect WES. So let's key up that. All right, red, yellow, green. Fights on, fights on. Last one, banger maneuvered directly nose low. Looks like he's staying in plane here. Little bit of a climb. Might just be the camera angle, but now look at this high aspect shot. Banger's going to try to avoid Heron's nose. Oh, surprisingly, Heron does the same thing and doesn't seek that high aspect shot. Seeing a little bit of maneuver in the vertical. This is definitely different than the last fight. And, yep, Heron's going to put him right in the nose there. That should be a lot of health taken. Ooh, about three quarters of his health on that one engagement. Now they're going to try to rapidly, as they can, get their noses back on. Not pulling a super amount of G's, but you see both of their throttles being all the way up. And then Banger's going to try to not get, there's another high aspect shot. Look at Heron just putting that Wes right on him. That was quick. Very, very quick kills in that iteration. Crazy how good that AI is at those high aspect shots. This Heron AI was trained using reinforcement learning in league play. So if you want to think about playing different versions of itself and then getting the best versions. And if you don't know what reinforcement learning is, definitely check out my video above. That'll give you a good, real quick explanation of it. I do want to bring two caveats to this fight up at this point. Number one, the AI is given almost perfect data on this fight. And number two, the AI's engagements are almost always high aspect. You've probably heard me talk about that many times. The AI has data on almost everything about itself and its opponent, except for maybe his gas, where Banger obviously doesn't have that knowledge of his adversary. You can easily quickly say this is an unfair advantage, but this also proves the point of what DARPA is trying to get after here is Banger, if he was displayed this information somehow, he likely wouldn't even be able to digest that mass of data without some very helpful AI situation tools at his availability. That second caveat of that high aspect shot is another kind of double-edged sword here in human versus AI. Humans trained to, quote, saddle up behind the opponent to get in a good position for a gun kill from behind or low aspect, where the AI priority is to just place the opponent in a Wes and it doesn't care about the aspect. This means the AI is repeatedly taking those high aspect shots because that's what's available to it. This isn't something humans train to regularly and is generally considered a low probability of kill and actually inflicting damage because of how hard it is. In this simulation, there aren't any actual bullets flying, so there's no compensation for the many intricate factors involved and the time delay of those bullets reaching the target. That being said, it's very likely that AI would be more capable of executing these high aspect shots with superhuman information, aggregation, speed, accuracy, etc. This is extremely exciting stuff, in my opinion. DARPA's objectives were definitely achieved here in demonstrating what AI is capable of, hopefully building a little bit of that trust. The AI defeated the human handily, but I don't want that to be your takeaway from watching this video. What most people miss in discussing this, and especially the media, is that this isn't an us versus them thing. It's not a human versus AI. This is about improving the AI so that we can pair with that AI, that human-machine teaming, so that we can build trust in each other and then play off each other's strengths while mitigating our weaknesses. If the AI is able to focus on aggregating data and precise tactical engagements, all the really nitinoid things that AI is good at really quickly, then that frees up the human adaptable mind to deal with the situational context and operational strategy, the mission, the fog and friction of war that will inevitably be there in future conflict with an advanced competitor. We saw this shift in human-machine teaming once humans were dethroned in the games of chess and go. AI may be better than humans at these games, but a human-machine team is far more capable than either one of them by themselves. Each brings strengths that need to be trusted and leveraged to bring those new capabilities to bear. The future is bright. This is really exciting stuff. Really great advancements here. Good job, Animal. Let's get this human-machine teaming right, Because let's face it, AI is becoming smarter and more capable each and every day. Let's get on the same team here. If you like this great AI discussion, definitely subscribe to the channel. Smash the thumbs up. There's a lot of advancements in AI every day, and I'm definitely optimistic looking to the future. So check out some of my other videos. I got lots of cool stuff out there on what AI is doing inside the military and outside. This is Jerry. See ya!